I'm Blake Gex, and this is another nuclear reaction. What's up, survivors? So today I'm getting back to the infinite list with another request. This one was asked for by Reflector and Trashbag Lily, and this is Draconian's Death Come Near Me. Now, if memory serves me, this was one of the songs that did not make the cut for the Gothic Metal Journey last year. Can't believe that was last year already. And so it ended up on the list, so it'll be good to finally get to this and hear it for the first time. Now, according to Metal Archives, it's off their demo Dark Oceans We Cry, so I'm guessing this is from early on in their career. I'm going to check this out, and afterward I'll get to the lyrics and talk about the song meaning, give my personal perspective. If you're new to the channel and you're wondering why my videos are longer than other reaction channels, that's exactly why. I do a full lyrical breakdown and review after the reaction itself. It's like a total immersive experience for you guys, and that's very much what Nuclear Reactions is about. Alright, Draconian Death Come Near Me. This is a long one, man. This is like 15 and a half minutes long, so I think I'm just going to dive into this. Before I do, the usual, check out patreon.com/nuclearreactions. You can join for as low as $2 a month. Check out the merch store, Yield Nuclear Shop, the second brand new merch store, Death Earth Clothing, and the Facebook group, Mushroom Cloud. Links to all these things will be in the description beneath the video. Don't forget to share your love and support for the channel and to enhance your experience as part of the nuclear family. All right. I still remember how fun the Gothic Metal Journey was on this channel. I hope to do a part two sometime. I can't promise it'll be sometime soon because I think those genre-specific journeys on the channel, it's going to be a while before I get back to them because there's just so much, there's such a mix of content on the way for you guys, like new releases, items from the infinite list, Patreon requests, there's like a whole kind of variety of things that I want to get to, so it's going to be a while before I get back to doing these genre-based journeys on the channel, but that will happen again eventually. For now, let's get into this. Death Come Near Me by Draconian. Let's jump in 3, 2, 1, go. I can already tell this is going to be a zone out kind of song. Just sit back, have some of this, relax, and just get into the vibe. Yeah, turn up the volume. Already digging that atmosphere. Feeling of this atmosphere in the background here. It feels just like very, very icy and very powerful. Part. Okay, we're off to a very intriguing start, about 3 minutes in so far. Yeah, I call that atmosphere icy because it has like a cold feeling to me. Like that's a general vibe that I get from it, and that's a good thing. I really like that. You know what? One of the initial things that I thought as soon as the song started, oddly enough, I mean, this is, you know, gothic slash doom metal from what I understand. But this is almost like something I would listen to if I'm hiking. Not even almost. This is something I would probably listen to if I'm on a long hike in the woods. Like, the atmosphere, for some reason, is just so appropriate for that. So I really like this so far. It's off to a very very excellent start. And the guitar I really like as well. And yeah, it's just, immediately there's a very sorrowful feeling to the song. So I'm assuming that's tied into the lyrics. I mean, after all, this is gothic metal, right? So we will get into that after the reaction itself. But anyway, as far as the music is concerned, so far I really like it. So let's jump back in. The atmosphere also gives it a slightly folk metal feeling. Okay, this is already skyrocketing into amazing territory. That's all I'm going to say. I really like the vocal harmony between the female vocals and the harshes. And it's not like super fast-paced, it's not super aggressive, but it manages to balance its own kind of heaviness with that cold kind of atmosphere. And once again, there is like a slight, to my ears anyway, there's like a slight folky element running through this song, which is very much owed to the atmosphere itself, and I really like that. And maybe that's just how I'm interpreting it as I'm listening to this. I don't know. But whatever that sound is, whatever that particular style is, in terms of the atmosphere, I really like it. So this song is, so far, very impressive. Let's dive back in. The transitional parts to this are also extremely amazing. They're very well done.
Behind the shadow of life, the lost hopes are craving. I seek the night and hope to find love. So I drown in the silence of life's short eternity. The tears fills the void in my heart astray.
This is incredible. This is like one of the best songs I've ever heard. Like ever. Not just this week, not just this month. Like, it's way up there. The guitar right here is just so emotional sounding. Again, there's an icy atmosphere. Okay, this song is so well done. It just takes epic to like a completely different level. To the point where like the word just doesn't suffice to describe this anymore. Like, this is like, again, what I'm saying this right now, first time listen, more than likely one of my all-time favorite songs in terms of metal. I mean, this is like, yeah, and you know, I'm gonna do that. Like, I've gotten a few suggestions. I recently did a top 10 favorite metal albums of all time, and I've been considering doing a top 10 favorite metal songs of all time. I'm gonna tell you right now, this is a possible contender for that list. I'm just putting that out there. This is very, very excellent. Beyond excellent. This is like a phenomenal song to me. And we're not even finished. We're only 9 minutes in. So this is like... And you know, I reacted to one other Draconian song. And I've heard like one or two other songs as well that friends have played. But as far as I remember, those don't even compare to this one. Like, this one is on a completely different level. So I'm really, really loving this one. It has so much in it that there's just so much to unpack musically that I can't even begin... to begin, at least not yet, you know, and I still want to finish the rest of the song before I try and break down the music a little bit. But yeah, I mean, it's just epic, it's just captivating, it's atmospheric, it's emotional, it has everything going for it, and it's done very, very well. So with that being said, let's see how it wraps up from here. Let's finish it up.
You have
really like the drumming here as well. It's perfect for this part of the song. This is so well done. This is probably the best atmosphere I've ever heard in a metal song. Like, listen to this. This is crazy good. This guitar right here, this is like incredible. I wish it wasn't fading out because it sounds so good. Okay, I'm just going to sit and take a moment to be impressed by that song. 15 and a half minutes, almost, of sheer perfection, man, you know? I gotta say it again. Like, if I end up doing a top 10 metal songs of all time, this one is going to be a serious, serious contender for that list. This is probably one of the best songs I've heard in years, if not, once again, of all time in the metal genre. This was worth every minute, every second of listening to this, and I'm so glad that I finally got to this. One less item on the infinite list, but one more item added to my playlist. That's for sure. That's for damn sure. This had everything. I mean, this had like an epic atmosphere. It had a chilling atmosphere. It had great guitar. It had great drumming. Great dual vocals. You know, they call them Beauty and the Beast vocals, but I really liked the harmonizing that went on. And this was just like, everything about this was just perfect. This is probably the most this is probably the song that has come the closest to perfection of any song that I've ever reacted to on this channel. I'm just going to say that right now. Like, and I can't believe that this song was from a demo. Like, that's crazy to me. It's from Dark Oceans We Cry, according to the Metal Archives. Death Come Near Me. It's track 5 on that demo. And that to me is shocking. Like, and like I said, I've heard several of their songs already. Like 3 or 4 of them at most, I think. I think the most I've heard is about 4. And those are like, I consider those to be very, very good. Don't get me wrong. But the fact that this is off a demo early in the band's career, and the fact that this sounds so much even more amazing than the songs I've already checked out, that says something about the band. And it definitely, for sure, makes me want to hear a lot more about this band. So, you know, there are at least 2 or 3 more Draconian songs, by the way, on the Infinite list. So you can be damn sure I'm going to be checking those out in the future. But yeah, this one is like, it had everything. It had everything going for it. It was just, there's nothing to complain about, nothing to criticize, nothing to pick apart about this song. I even like the fade out on this one. So this was just very well put together. It was just like, everything about this was just what it needed to be, and it all came together perfectly. It was like the perfect storm of great gothic slash doom metal, whatever you'd like to label this as. I don't really care. I label it as amazing. And yeah, this is like, you know, and I'm not a person to like get really hyperbolic in my reactions. Like, that's not really what I'm about. Like, I'm going to be honest with you in my reactions. If I dislike something, if I hate something, if I like something but don't love it, I'm going to tell you guys. But this one, I honestly love this song. And for a song like this to blow me away, and unexpectedly so, that's a big fucking deal. So musically, I thought this was like beyond incredible, completely blew me away, shocked me by how good it was, and I was so captivated by the song that I didn't even want to pause it. And as it went on, it just kept getting better and better and better, and it never stopped. So musically, nothing else to say other than that I more than love this, and like I said, I'm going to end up being surprised if this doesn't make my top 10 metal songs of all time. At least the way I feel right now, based on this, you know, first time reaction, that's very much the way I feel about this music. Like, so that's all I can really say for the musical department. Now let's get to the lyrics and see what the song is talking about, man. I'll be very surprised if the lyrics don't blow me away as well at this point. All right. Death, come near me. By day I sleep, at night I weep. Oh, death, come near me. Be the one for me. Be the one who stays. My rivers are frozen and mischosen, and the shadows around me sicken my heart. Oh, death, come near me and stay by my side. Hear my silent cry. In sadness I'm veiled, to the cross I am nailed, and the pain around me freezes my world. My cold world. In life I've failed, for years I've wailed, frozen in time left behind. The rapture of grief is all to find. The rapture of grief, I like that. Behind the shadow of life, the lost hopes are grieving. I seek the night and hope to find love, so I drown in the silence of life's short eternity. The tears fill the void in my heart astray. Embrace me now, delightful ease, give me a world of wondrous peace, calm the desperate scream in my heart. Save me from this empty, cold world. O life, you have killed me, so spare me from this cauldron of misery. In life I cry, away I fly, chosen to fall within these walls. The rapture of grief is all. Shed a tear for the loss of innocence, for the forsaken spirit to ache in us. Cry for the heart who surrenders in pain, for the solitude of those left behind. Behold the pain and sorrow of the world. Dream of a place away from this nightmare. Give us love and unity under the heart of night. O death, come near us and give us life. In this world of pain, I am better off dead. Give me love or give me death. Death, come near me, I have summoned you. Okay, just as well written as I was hoping. And, but you know, typical fare for gothic metal in some ways, in terms of what it's talking about. Yeah, death is ever the subject of gothic and doom metal, you know, or at the very least, the longing for or the romanticization of death. But, you know, most people think they want death until the time actually comes. You know, unless they're suicidal, that's different. But aside from that, I think most people who talk about or think very heavily about their own death, you know, seeing it as something positive, I think they more so want to be death adjacent rather than altogether dead. You know, yeah, you know, it's coming up on October fairly soon. You know, we're almost done with August, and Halloween is not all that far off. You know, people are already making posts about it on Facebook. And, you know, already I've seen ads for some of these places where people go to get scared. And I don't mean like haunted hayride bullshit. You know, I mean like legitimately scared for their lives. Like situations where people like sign up to get kidnapped and thrown into the trunks of cars, where they go to places where they really feel this intense fear on like a deep psychological level. Like, that's the thing. Like, these places are becoming more and more popular. And, like, they're so legit that people need to sign a waiver that they won't sue or press charges if things go too far for them. You know, it's a very intense kind of experience. And, you know, to me, the appeal of that for a lot of people is the feeling of being close to the idea of death, right? It's like, to really fearing for their lives, but still coming out the other side of things in one piece, to where they can go about their lives as normal after that. And, you know, I think that's also the case with people who want to be terrified by horror films, and even when it comes to sex, people who are extremely into very, very heavy BDSM. I think it's the thrill for some people of being so on the cusp of pain and death, and then coming back from that, feeling this intense set of emotions that average people don't feel in life. There was actually this a pretty interesting film called Strangeland. It was filmed in, I think we came out in the late 90s. And it starred Dee Snider from Twisted Sister. And I think he wrote the film too. He wrote the story. And he played the main antagonist, who very much had that kind of personality. Like, where he basically got off on, in his case, extreme piercing and body torture in order to feel close to death. And he would kidnap people, and he would do the same thing to them. And he was, like, basically so twisted that he thought he was helping them in some sick way, you know? Like, he played a really good good sicko in that movie, actually. The movie itself, like, wasn't super amazing, but he did a good job with that character. Robert Englund was in that, too. It was an interesting film. But anyway, the point that I'm trying to make here is that I think this song is not necessarily about someone seeking some kind of thrill from death or the brink of death. I think it's about someone who's so empty and so devoid of feeling anything that out of sheer despair, they're willing to embrace and endure the most negative and dangerously death-oriented emotions and physical feelings that are humanly possible. Which is, that's a pretty dark place to be, but a lot of people get there. And again, you know, I come back to that word, anhedonia. That's one of my favorite words, you know, which means the lack of any feeling or emotion. And I think that's a real thing, man. You know, back in the early 2000s, in my hometown in Jersey, back when the goth and emo scenes were really big back then, and for better or worse, there was an epidemic of teenagers cutting themselves. I remember it being a pretty big controversy in the high school there. And let me put it this way. As far as I could tell at that time, there were like three basic categories of kids who were cutting themselves. There were the ones who were doing it as a legitimate suicide attempt. Then there were the ones who were doing it to get attention because they thought that it was hip and trendy. And yeah, I'm sorry to say, but that was a real thing, you know, and probably still is. And then there were the ones who were doing it not because they wanted to actually end their lives, but because they wanted to feel something. You know, they were so at the end of their ropes, but they didn't want to die. Because if you think about it, who could honestly say whether or not there's feeling after death? Like, in other words, no matter what you believe or don't believe, I think the pain being expressed in this song comes from an emotional void within oneself. So if there's even the off chance that only absolute oblivion follows death, whether you're religious or non-religious, optimistic or nihilistic, if there's even an off chance that that's a possibility, I think that was undoable for most people in that situation and in that mental headspace. And, you know, of course, I'm glad because that kind of barrier, you know, probably saved a lot of lives. That psychological barrier, I mean, you know. So I think that some people are so drained of emotion that they will willingly seek pain and injury, even bringing themselves as far to the cusp of death as they dare go, as a last-ditch kind of attempt at some kind of emotional connection. Because most human beings are emotional creatures, unless you're like a, you know, a sociopath or a psychopath. And for whatever reason, when those natural feelings are drained from us, we seek it elsewhere, anywhere we can find. You know, just like a starving person will desperately look for almost anything to eat, someone who is emotionally famished will try and find anything to fill that void. So I know that gothic and doom metal song lyrics typically express concepts like this ad nauseum for a lot of people. But to me, it's a very human actualization of a very real process going on in a lot of people's minds. And yes, there's some obvious romanticization happening here, as is bound to happen within the genre of music. But I think that stems from a combination of two things. On one hand, I think it's artistic license, And on the other, I think it's to some degree a coping mechanism. But there's also a third side to this, which is that I actually think it can be healthy and even healing to contemplate the idea of death and all of which that entails, as long as it's done in a way that reminds you at the end of the day to preserve life itself. Because as the old saying goes, or at the very least a saying that I've read in recent years, hope I can quote it correctly here. It was something like, how did it go? Basically, it was like, stay and focus on death as long as you want, as much as you want, during your time on this earth. But also cherish life, because when you're no longer alive, death will be of absolutely no interest to you. And it's, you know, that's true, you know. So there's something to be said for understanding something or trying to shine a light on something that most people purposefully avoid. And, you know, metal always does that. Metal always explores concepts that are very dark that, you know, in many cases are on the fringes of what society wants to get involved with or even contemplate. And that's a good thing because it gets you thinking and it expands your mind in ways that it otherwise might not be expanded. And so gothic metal and doom metal are both doing their own thing in that regard. And you have to respect that. So, because think about these lyrics here. It doesn't say death take me. It says death come near me and stay by my side. Hear my silent cry. So he's seeking the object of death as an emotional comfort, something for his life to revolve around that has some sort of emotional meaning. Even if that meaning is inherently negative, at least it's something, you know. Any port in a storm, in other words, you know. So, no matter how many times I hear a gothic metal song that deals with sorrow and this kind of courtship of death, I don't write it off as being just cookie cutter. Because I think there's a wealth of knowledge and understanding to be had about the human psyche by getting into the deeper meaning of songs like this. So, you know, I gotta give credit for the lyrics, even though it's something that I have touched upon before with reactions. Especially on the gothic metal journey. But nevertheless, I think it's very well written, and it expresses something that, no matter how many times I think you cover it, it always circles back to the fact that it requires some deep introspective, you know, contemplation and reflection that, once again, a lot of people aren't brave enough to, you know, really explore. And so it's very interesting, man, you know. And in terms of the music, this, like, they absolutely killed it in every possible way. This was perfect to me, one of my favorite songs of all time, and I know those are big words, but as of right now, as of this first time listen, I mean that. So, great musically, more than great, but I'm running out of words to express that. Great lyrically, great in terms of the message, and it's a thinking man's song, and a thinking man's genre, and this was fantastic. So, in terms of rating, I'm going to give this one a very strong, you know what's coming, 12 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock, and I can't wait to hear more Draconian, and I appreciate the request. Once again, it's one less item from the infinite list. I will be getting to much more in the days and weeks to come, and there's so much more new content on the way for you guys. I'm excited for you guys to see it, and I'm excited to check out some more music for myself. So, all right, that is it for this reaction. Thank you guys for checking this out with me. Thank you for subscribing. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so now. All it takes is one click. It takes 2 seconds and it costs nothing. Click that bell if you want to get notifications. Check out patreon.com/nuclearreactions. And that is all I've got for you guys. So much love and respect to the nuclear family. And until next time, I will catch you all sooner than you think.